And for this cause, he is the mediator of the New Testament.
He is the mediator of the New Repeat that. And for this cause, I want to
repeat. And for this cause.
And for this cause.
He is the mediator of the New Testament.
He is the mediator of the New Testament. Which cause? The cause that he died and he resurrected. Then he entered with his own what? Blood. He is the mediator of the New Testament. Not a spirit of Father who eats in Shema. That one is not a mediator. Not Hail Mary, the mother of Jesus. That one is not the mediator. The mediator is Jesus. Why? For this cause. Which cause? He entered once and for all with his own blood. Now, because he did that, he is the mediator. We have a problem with people which go before God in the name of their spiritual father, by the grace of my spiritual father, Shepherd Bushir. They don't understand that for the cause of Christ entering into the holy tabernacle with his own blood, he is the mediator. They want spiritual fathers who drive cars to mediate for them in the New Testament church. That is a clear symbol they are not in the New Testament church. If you find yourself needing a spiritual father for you to enter into the New Testament grace, you are not in the New Testament church. Here it is. I want you to repeat this.
And for this cause,
He
is the mediator of the New Testament.
Jesus is the mediator of the New Testament.
That by means of death,
His death,
for the redemption of the transgressions that were under the First Testament.
So in the First Testament, there was no grace.
They which are called might receive the promise
is
of
it eternal everyone?
Inheritance.
Is it everyone? Only those who are what? Called. If you are not called, you follow spiritual fathers. Only us who are called, you know that, we have a spiritual father with heaven. Those who are not called, they will find another mediate. The book of 1 Timothy chapter number 5. So chapter number 2, verse number 5. It says, there is one man between men and God. The man Jesus Christ. Because of the death, he is the mediator. Verse number 16.
For where a testament is, there must also of necessity be the death of the testator.
People should be afraid of this verse. Where there is a testament, it is necessary that the testator dies. Which testament is this? New Testament. Who is the testator?
Jesus
Christ. So he died for the testament. But we've got people on who are founders of the church. I'm the founder of this church.
Because
I'm the founder of the Bible, what church? When there is a church, it is necessary
for the founder, to die.
But we're founders. I saw a lot of people on Facebook, I'm the founder of this, I'm the founder of that, I'm the founder of that church. Hebrews 9:16. For where there is a testament, it is necessary that the founder
dies.
Must die. That's why Jesus died for the New Testament church. That's why the book of Hebrews chapter number 12 says, you did not come unto the mountain which is dark and with the smoke, but you come unto the church of the firstborn. We have come out of the church of Jesus Christ who died for it. Now, if you're a founder and you're eating shim, when are you going to die for your church? For where there is a testament, it is necessary, founder, say, that you die.